The audio you're about to hear is a piece rescued from a flood. In fact, two floods and a fire. Can you believe it? I draw your attention to the audio's content. In the world of social media, it's as if some of the issues of access, of cost, are being repeated. I call this audio Chasing Technology. The interview was recorded 21 years ago. Proof, may I say, that history is the only true measure of time. Lousy. I never liked video.
Hello, I'm talking to Maria Altman, who's worked in and around the media for 15 years. She's worked for Spanish TV, taken film to Nepal, and worked with corporate video in Australia. But she gets the most pleasure and professional satisfaction from alternate media networks. Maria Altman has also been a station coordinator for Australia's first cable TV station, CTV1.
Radio with pictures.
CTV1.
The radio picture station.
Maria, you've been around for a long time now. How did you get started?
Hello, Ruth. Well, where do I start?
As a child, I migrated with my parents. I was a musical person. I was in every show that was around. I got a lot of lead roles. I got interested in media stage. From stage, I went backstage. From backstage, I went into theatre and music, you know, as a performer again, and then stage manager, production manager, producer, lighting, sound. From there, I went to radio, and it's with radio that I found journalism and film.
And what are you doing now?
Now I'm producing at CTV1 next year, I'm not sure yet, but I've got two shows on cable television in Sydney. One's called Connecting Australia, which is an environmental video training forum and with youth. And then the other program, which is really brilliant, is called Radio with Pictures. It's putting sound with images. Radio with Pictures.
That sounds fascinating. Now, every time I've seen you working, you seem to be doing it on a shoestring. How do you manage that?
A lot of the time I'm working on a shoestring. I think in the most rewarding aspect is that I work very much with people power. The thing that we're all learning at the moment about media, particularly the alternative media, is that production costs a lot. And the only way that we can actually get around these costs is by the old saying, it's not what you know, it's who you know. But to keep that really honest means that you have to have a lot of good liaison with the people that you're actually, you know, connecting with, whether it's interviews like we're doing right now, or whether it's that you get a lot of in-kind contribution to be able to move around. You can't act like you're the ABC or SBS or Channel 10 in the way that I work. A lot of the work that I actually do, SBS and the ABC would never document. Because production costs so much, we can't always produce our stories. So we have a certain amount of the day with the local issues or the topical news that we're actually delivering or talking about. And then after that, we keep the station open by running Radio with Pictures as a radio picture station.
Do you enjoy it?
I love it.
Okay, so what's the drawbacks of working on your own, virtually freelancing almost everything you do?
Freelancing's the key word there. On my own, you don't work on your own. You can't. The whole thing about video, film and production is the fact that you have to know how to work with people, you have to know how to communicate, and you really have to know how to work with a team. The good stuff about my work is that I have constant contact with people, that I'm rewarded by the news that I report on or the issues or, you know, just the stories that I get. The drawback, because I don't have money, I find myself exhausted a lot, which is a problem. People don't realise that all the accommodation, all the transport, all the fringe benefits are actually very, very important.
So how do you get by without it?
People power. Like you giving me a lift around town, helping me do the story that I've done on the Lismore Women's Festival. You know, even though I didn't have a crew, I had people concerned and as worried as I was that I wasn't going to get the children's concert, you know, that I wasn't going to get this person, even though she's not a really famous person, she deserved to be documented. person I'm talking about, particularly who's just starting out. Now, my footage is valuable. In 10 years' time, that woman
could be famous.
Hot stuff, and it happened here in Lismore.
What sort of events do you prefer to cover?
I think social events where I actually learn something or feel the issue or story is really valuable to the rest of society. That's why corporate video didn't work for me. I've had lunch at Doyle's, I've, you know, been all over the place in boats, planes, whatever, but that stuff wasn't as important. Getting around and talking to people in the way that I do on these stories and having the connections that I do with the work that I do gives me a lot back. It makes me feel like my life is my work and my work is my life.
Mm-hmm. And what's about the future? What do you hope to do in the future?
Well, I'm working on a lot of things. I've got a lot of little stories, both for the TV, for the women's movement, to tidy up. I'm a director, so I like turning around and, you know, delivering experience on screen. But I'm working on a few dramas as well for coming festivals. Mm-hmm.